Welcome folks, nice to see you again on this Thursday lunchtime. Also a warm welcome to the ladies on the phones. Hope you're all well. We will wait for a wee moment to let some more people join us. So as usual, the words for today are in the description box below. And if you want to contact us, Ian's number is there also. Hopefully most people have joined us now. So let's take a moment to calm our minds and our hearts and our spirit. The peace of Christ be with us all. Shall we say together? No one has seen God. God's only Son, who is nearest to the Father's heart, has made him known. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Hear us, Shepherd of Israel, you who lead Joseph like a flock, you who sit enthroned between the cherubim, shine forth, awaken your might, come and save us. Restore us, O God, make your face shine on us, that we may be saved. Today's psalm is Psalm 13. Psalm 13. For the director of music, a psalm of David. How long, O Lord, will you forget me forever? How long will you hide your face from me? How long must I wrestle with my thoughts, and every day have sorrows in my heart? How long will my enemy triumph over me? Look on me and answer, O Lord, my God. Give light to my eyes, or I will sleep in death. My enemy will say, I have overcome him, and my foes will rejoice when I fall. But I trust in your unfailing love. My heart rejoices in your salvation. I will sing to the Lord, for he has been good to me. Amen. We shall now say the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. We continue in the Gospels, and we're still on Luke 9, verses 46 to 48. An argument started among the disciples as to which of them would be the greatest. Jesus, knowing their thoughts, took a little child and made him stand beside him. Then he said to them, "Whoever welcomes this little child in my name welcomes me, and whoever welcomes me welcomes the one who sent me. But he who is least among you all, he is the greatest." Amen. Shall we pray together? God, our hope, we rejoice that you became flesh and made your dwelling among us, and we long for your return. As we wait for your coming again and for the end of sorrow, pain, and death, we are bold to ask in the name of Jesus for your kingdom to be made known among us now. Lead us by the groaning of your spirit to pray for ourselves and our suffering world. We shall now have a time of silent prayer, where we will pray for the things which are on your heart and the things which God lays upon your heart. We pray in silence. Let us pray together. Eternal God, for whom all people wait and search, even when they do not know it, open the eyes of the blind that they might see you. Open our eyes that have been closed by fear or blinded by self-pity, that we might see you even in the anxieties and uncertainties of our time, and in seeing you be both comforted by your presence and made uncomfortable enough to seek to serve you, who is and was and is to come. Amen. Eternal God, you have set before us the great hope that your kingdom will come on earth, and have taught us to pray for its coming. Make us ready to thank you for the signs of its dawning, and to pray and work for the perfect day, when your will shall be done on earth as it is in heaven. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. May God himself, the God of peace, sanctify you through and through. May your whole spirit, soul and body be kept blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. The one who calls you is faithful, and he will do it. Amen. Thank you, God, for listening to our prayers. Hopefully, we'll see you all again soon. Stay safe. Bye for now.